So we are in the lecture of regression, and the next topic is to study the relationship between regression and causation. So let's say that we perform an experiment and we see that there is a very strong relationship between the clearance of creatinine that measures the kidney function and the blood pressure, and the, not the blood pressure, the concentration of lead in blood. So, and we see that this clearance decreases with higher concentrations of lead. So can we call, can we say that lead exposure causes kidney malfunctioning? The regression seems to say so. So the higher the concentration of lead, the less the kidney is functioning. But it could be the opposite. It could be that the kidney malfunctioning causes lead rise in blood. So we don't know from a regression, we cannot know which one of the two is the cause of the other. It could, so that is one problem. A second problem is that there could be a third cause that we are not measuring. And this third cause is making the two variables to be correlated or to have a good regression between each other. Correlation is just a quick way of summarizing a linear regression. Okay, so let's say that there is a very strong correlation between the number of ice creams you have and the number of sunburns that you have. So it is not that the ice creams causes you to have sunburns or the opposite. So having a sunburn causes you to have an ice cream. There is a common cause that is the sun, and this sun causes you to have higher number of ice creams, and it is also causing higher number of sunburns. So this external third cause is the one we have not measured. Here you have another example. So here you have the total US highway fatality rate as a number of 15 fatalities in 100,000 people, let's say. And here you have the number of fresh lemons imported to USA from Mexico. So the higher number of lemons you import, the more the fatality rate decreases. So, but there is no real relationship between the two. The common relationship is time. So this, with time, so here we have the years. So with time, the number of fresh lemons imported has been rising, and also with time, the highway fatality rate has been decreasing. So that makes the external third cause makes the two to be very much correlated. So there is a way of using regression to, determine causation, but you need to put models on that. So you need to compare several models. So let's say that you're interested in the relationship between confidence, alcohol, and sociability. And you have two competing models. So in the first model, confidence and alcohol are independent, and both affect sociability. And in the second model, alcohol affects confidence, and then confidence affects sociability. So to determine which of the two models is more compatible with the data, what we can do is to perform a regression of sociability as a function of confidence. So if we analyze these residuals, so if alcohol affects sociability through confidence, then once we have explained, so all the information that alcohol brings to explain sociability is condensed in the confidence. And then if we now take the regression, the residuals of the first regression, and compute a regression with alcohol, so it is residuals versus alcohol. In the second model, we would see that there is no relationship. In the second model, there is no relationship because all the information, so this residuals are in the scale of sociability. So in the second model, all the information that alcohol was bringing in was condensed in confidence. And we have already explained that. So in the first model, it is not the case. So confidence is explaining part of the sociability, but alcohol would also explain another part. So in the regressions, in the regression residuals that we have from sociability versus confidence, part of those residuals are caused by the alcohol. And that part could not be explained by confidence alone. So in the first model, we should see non-significant coefficients of alcohol affecting the residuals. While in the second model, these coefficients should be it is just the opposite. In the first model, alcohol would give significant coefficients, while in the second model, alcohol should give non-significant coefficients. So if we have significant coefficients, we reject model two. We can never accept model one. This is something that you already know from hypothesis testing. So you can reject an hypothesis, but you can never accept the null hypothesis. So if you have significant coefficients, you reject this model, and you cannot reject the model one. So this is all for causation. And there's a whole field trying to analyze causation through these kind of models. And see you next time.